gigante Nephilim abatido por Estados Unidos de América en Afganistán. Hola amigos. ¿Cómo están? La publicación de hoy es un gran misterio, una gran conspiración de la jefatura del ejército de Estados Unidos de América. Este misterio oculto ocurrió con la intervención militar de Afganistán, donde el ejército mató a un gigante Nephilim de más de 4 metros de altura en una cueva. Hicimos una traducción de lo que se va a tratar en el video, aunque nuestro nivel de inglés no es tan bueno, todos los integrantes de nuestro blog intentamos dar lo mejor que pudimos y traducimos todo el reportaje. No obstante, recomendamos asistir el video hasta el final para ver todo el desarrollo y comprender totalmente que esto no fue ni es una broma. Este fue un hecho donde ocultaron la verdad a todo el mundo, este es un gran misterio sin resolver. Pero aquí les trajimos los testimonios de los soldados y como prueba de que no es una noticia fake les recordamos a nuestros seguidores que la trayectoria de Coast to Coast, AM Radio es una de las más calificadas respecto a audiencia y los temas que tratan, además que está considerada como una programación seria y que no hacen fake de noticias. Entonces vamos a la presentación de este misterio oculto que ocurrió en la intervención militar de Afganistán. Como antes dije, en donde el ejército mató a un gigante Nephilim de más de 4 metros de altura en una cueva y que según afirman, murió un único soldado en acción. El gobierno se llevó el cadáver del Nephilim para Estados Unidos de América y ya no se supo más nada de él, aunque en el presente salió a la luz la noticia. En una entrevista realizada por el investigador Marsugi de Politics, Prophecy y The Supernatural, varios soldados declararon que en 2002 se encontraron con ese ser mientras estaban buscando a una unidad perdida en una parte del país. En la entrevista, el soldado le dice al investigador que su unidad pasó por un camino donde pastoreaban cabras y que ahí cerca había una cueva donde el equipo notó cosas extrañas, rocas, restos óseos y un equipo de comunicaciones americano totalmente destruido. Según declaraciones del soldado. Mientras sucedía eso, el escuadrón fue sorprendido y atacado por un hombre de, al menos 4 a 6 metros de altura, ese ser tenía el pelo largo, rojo y mató a un soldado operador de nombre, Dan, con un arma tipo pica. En ese momento el escuadrón abrió fuego y disparó en la cara de la criatura y lo mató. El tiempo total del combate fue de tan solo 30 segundos. Las declaraciones del soldado marcan que, mientras nos lamentábamos por la muerte de nuestro compañero, llegó un helicóptero y tomó a la criatura y se la llevó, era demasiado grande, no podía moverlo y olía como si fuese un cadáver en estado de descomposición. Además, el soldado declara que, luego de esa situación enviamos un comunicado a la base de que teníamos una criatura muy grande, posiblemente humana. Poco después el comando del ejército nos ordenó que reescribiéramos los informes de la operación. Así que tuvimos que volver a escribir en la forma que ellos lo ordenaron. El gigante estaba armado con un arma similar al tipo lanza Nephilim. George Norrie, el conductor de Coast to Coast, AM Radio, entrevistó otro testigo, el piloto del avión que transportó el cadáver del gigante hacia una base en Ohio, en Estados Unidos de América. Dice el piloto que tenía 6 dedos en las manos y los pies. Sus pies medían unos 60 a 80 centímetros, fue difícil determinar su altura debido a que estaba en una posición fetal, pero el cadáver era de un hombre de aproximadamente 4 metros, pesaba más de 700 kilogramos y tenía 6 dedos en las manos y pies. La conspiración del Nephilim. El investigador de Politics, Prophecy y The Supernatural, afirmó que la cúpula del gobierno tiene un interés muy marcado en mantener la historia bien encubierta. Este soldado testificó que en la base de Afganistán fue un caso muy nombrado y conocido como, el gigante de Kandahar. Empezamos a oír algunos comentarios sobre una unidad en la que mataron a una persona muy alta, un gigante de más de 4 metros. Al principio no pensé mucho en eso, pero luego descubrí que la persona que mataron era en realidad 3 veces la altura de un hombre común, tenía dedos adicionales en sus manos y pies y tenía el pelo rojo. Habíamos escuchado decir que habían matado a esa criatura dentro de una cueva, no era común escuchar eso, pero años más tarde, a mi regreso de Afganistán, conocí a otros miembros militares que no habían estado en las operaciones conmigo y me advirtieron que si mencionaba el hecho del gigante de Kandahar ellos lo sabrán. Él confesó que la historia suena ridícula. En primer lugar, uno piensa que esto tiene que ser una broma, un engaño, admitió el soldado. Luego, después las cosas se van aclarando y comienzas a darte cuenta que no es una broma. El soldado declaró que los locales cuentan historias, aparentemente ridículas, sobre gigantes que atacan poblados y que incluso hasta se comían a la gente. Oíamos a los locales hablar de gigantes que vivían en las cuevas y se comían a la gente. Eran caníbales. El conductor del programa criticó lo que llamó un esfuerzo del gobierno para encubrir la espectacular historia y amenazar a los soldados implicados para que no hablasen. Para el final del programa, el investigador hace alusión al derecho a la información de los ciudadanos. La gente tiene derecho a saber acerca de estas cosas. Si hay seres de 5 o 6 metros rondando por la tierra y nuestros soldados lo mataron, nosotros tenemos el derecho, como ciudadanos estadounidenses, a saber la verdad. Es decir, esto no debería estar clasificado como secreto militar. Esto es algo que necesitamos saber.
And come to find out that the person that they killed actually was 3 times the size of a man, had extra digits on their hand and digits on their feet, and had red hair. And a special unit had come in and wanted this target.
When I arrived at the venue where I was speaking, I phoned Richard and I told him we had yet another witness to the giant story. The initial story that was told to us was related verbatim by this man as fact. We then interviewed both of these men for our film, Watchers 10 DNA. There was also a dynamic of the story that I want to point out to you, and it's this. A while back, I interviewed Chief Joseph Riverwind right here on PPS Report. The chief and I spoke about what I have come to call the Nephilim Lance. This artifact was discovered in the backwoods of Michigan by an outdoorsman named Bob Shelley. Bob gave the original lance to the chief, and I'm holding a reproduction of it, a one-to-one reproduction of it, here as I speak. This weighs about 8.5 pounds. It's very heavy. And when you take this and lash it to a pole, it would be very difficult for a 6-foot man to wield. And yet, this is exactly what the shooter saw the giant wielding in Afghanistan. The reason I bring this up is because when I showed this lance to the shooter, he commented that this artifact was similar to what the giant of Kandahar was wielding. There is another dynamic I want to discuss before we run the clip from Watchers 10 DNA, which, by the way, has become viral. The fact that this giant had 6 fingers and 6 toes, as well as flaming red hair. There was also a stench that was as powerful as a skunk, but according to the shooter, smelled more like a pile of rotting corpses. Here's the clip, and you can decide for yourself if giants are alive and well and living in the present day.
You were in Afghanistan in 2002, and you were called into a very remote section of Afghanistan because a patrol had basically gone missing.
Exactly.
Okay,
exactly.
There's no villages around,
nothing.
For miles.
Right.
So it's very remote.
Yeah, very remote. So we flew in. They're about 4 kilometers. We're hiking through the same area where they were supposed to make one of their checkpoints, you know, one of their rally points. And before we'd left, there was all kinds of what happened with the ambush. But that was even odd because at point of ambush, you'd call for maybe close air support, something, okay? There was no calls made, just off the grid. So we're coming down a mountainside, and it was a nice path, a goat path. As we bent around this corner, you could see this opening of the cave. There's a cave if we're coming around. And then I see there's a lot of rocks, which is another oddity, and then bone matter. When I'm not close enough to identify what kind of bones, but I did see something I knew was a piece of our communications equipment. So instantly, we're thinking ambush, maybe animal, you know, could be anything. And there was enough room in front of this cave, but it had a sheer drop-off. But there was enough room that we actually got into a decent dispersal in case of ambush.
You see something coming out of the cave, and it's moving with a speed and agility that catches you off guard.
Everybody.
Everybody.
And he comes out. It was a man at least 12 to 15 feet in height. This This is a monster. Red beard, then his hair was longish, past the shoulder, a scarlet red. And Dan runs at him and starts shooting, which broke all of us into the reality. Because it was so surreal.
Now your training is kicking in.
Oh yeah, okay. Muscle memory. Right. Complete muscle memory. While Dan is moving at him, another bro of mine's laying down fire, and I start firing. He skewers Dan. He's now got him on this pike. It went through him. And he's still got him, and he's coming after more. We all just clicked in. I don't know what it was, but I remember we're all like, shoot him in the face, shoot him in the face. Our weapons components were M4s, we had 308s, and we had Barrett 50s. This is sounding longer than it took. We're talking 30 seconds. And he's taking multiple hits, and is still moving.
He talked about this giant being 1,100 pounds, anywhere from 10 to 15 feet long. And it was killed. It was apparently shot somewhere in a cave in Afghanistan. But before it was shot, it lunged at several of our troops, our soldiers. It may have even gorged somebody. It was just a bizarre, bizarre story. And it just sounds like the Nephilim from the Bible, doesn't it?
That's why we're so fascinated by this.
First off, can you imagine actually seeing something like this? A giant this big who's 12 feet to 15 feet tall. Take a good look at your ceiling. It's probably about 8 feet from the floor. Add another 4 feet on top of that to get 12 feet. Add 7 feet and you get a 15 footer. And as you go up, you've got to go out. That's how big this thing was. I can only imagine how the shooter and his battle buddies must have felt. And the fear that flashed through their minds, paralyzing them until their training kicked in and they brought the giant down. But not before the giant had impaled Dan on that very large pike.
And you have to assume that the giant is not alone, that the giant is not the only being living on this planet. There's got to be a whole school of them somewhere. You know, maybe he's got a female mate. Maybe he's got children. Who knows? Unfortunate that he had to attack our soldiers rather than be somewhat peaceful, but I guess that comes with the territory.
Dan was dead, okay? And why is a good man, probably one of the best men I know, now dead? Before I'd left, they were already starting what they call a 9-line, which is a medevac request. They're sending out a medevac request, then all of a sudden it's not a medevac request. All of a sudden we had a helicopter show up because, like I told you, it was a large precipice and a sheer drop. So the helicopter just came up from the drop. They had dropped netting, which is like cargo netting. It's like squares. We were told we had to bundle him up. And we get another bigger helicopter, but it's almost like a Jolly Green Giant used to look back in the day, that could get, you know, through this area. Because the mountains, you gotta remember, Chinooks could only go in certain places because they had enough lift. Mm-hmm. And so we got him on there. The thing was too big. We couldn't move it. It smelled worse than a skunk. A corpse that's been around for a while.
Really fell.
Oh, it was like a combination because of the, how do you put that, the persistence of a skunk smell. But once the helicopter came in, dropped its little hook, and off he goes. The communication was sent out that we had a very large, possible human creature.
There you are in the hills of Afghanistan. How many troop members are you with?
We had six on my crew. When we say hills of Afghanistan, for us, we did not fly into the wilderness. We actually flew into a base. I guess this thing was transloaded out of the mountains by a CH-47. But I could see that it did have the six fingers. I remember taking my foot up and placing it up next to its foot, and it was extremely large. We estimated at about 12 feet, give or take. What I can tell you is the weight of the thing, basically, it was approximately 1,500 pounds when it was getting on the aircraft. Now, if you take away the pallet weight and all the rigging that we had to hold this thing down, we figured it was around 1,100 pounds.
Of course we're upset. That's a given, okay? We lost a very good guy. But add to that, you're discussing something that even in our after-action report, they're saying rewrite it. And we had to rewrite it the way they wanted.
How many fingers?
Six. Oh, six.
Six toes.
And the nails were weird because if you see somebody that ever has, I don't know what it's called, but it's
like a fungus
on the nails, how they get pointy and they're like gnarly, that's what they look like.
As we showed you in the clip, the radio operator checked in and gave the report.
Bien, hasta aquí hemos presentado, Gigante Nephilim abatido por Estados Unidos de América en Afganistán. Espero les haya gustado y valoren nuestro esfuerzo por brindarles, día a día, material verdadero y de alta calidad. Somos un blog que no hacemos fake publicitario. Nuestra misión es tenerte informado de todos los misterios y develarlos para ti. No olvides dar like al video y suscribirte a nuestro canal YouTube para tener al momento las demás publicaciones que vayamos realizando. Visítanos en misteriostv.blogspot.com.br. Hasta el próximo video.